This is NDTV. And you're watching NDTV Hindu.
Listening to a verse written by a renowned Tamil poet. The entire month is of Margari is going to be filled with soothing musical delights. Singara Chenna is being graced by the colourful season of Margari. And Chennaites are lapping it up. We'll of course be bringing to you every day a small glimpse of the festive spirit. A very good evening to you and welcome to News Tonight with me, Ashmit Kumar. Hope you're having a ball this Margari, but a lot else is making news in the city. Let's take a look. No scams during my watch, says the former telecom minister Arun Shori. Hits out at tainted Raja for not following the first-come, first-served policy.
The point is not that Raja followed the first-come, first-served principle as he is saying. He did not follow any principle.
In the Justice vs. Judiciary spat, Justice Raghupathy reiterates his position, claims to have followed judicial conduct.
Do you think I am scared or confused? Never been.
Pudal prison, Chennai's Alcatraz is embarrassed again. First ganja, then murders, and now a prisoner escape. High security, gone for a toss. NDTV Hindu comes to the rescue of a supposedly overqualified graduate. In an impact development, graduate gets an appointment letter. Your canine friends are in for a treat. Get your furry darlings the best with the finest dermatologists in the city. Catch the stars over a cup of kappa during the season of Margari this winter. Tune into the musical delights. A quick glance to the national developments. Sources tell NDTV the Congress is likely to ask the government to probe into the RSS terror links in a resolution in the plenary session. Sources say the Congress has decided to change the phrase Hindu terror to right-wing terror. Sharad Pawar tells NDTV while it's necessary sometimes to tap phones in national interests, it's definitely wrong to do it on an indefinite period. India has never hesitated to emphasize its concern over China's presence in POK, Foreign Secretary Nirupama Rao tells NDTV. Well, DMK man Raja has been at the receiving end from all quarters now. The former telecom minister has become the favorite punching bag of the political community. And the latest to take a dig at the tainted politician has been Rajya Sabha MP and the telecom minister during the NDA regime from 2001-2004, Arun Shori.
Raja followed the first-come, first-served principle, as he is saying. He did not follow any principle. I was very proud of the fact, that a sector which had got a bad name for several years, which was mired in litigation, in which each of the operators had cases against other operators and against government, I was able to persuade them to withdraw all cases against each other and against government. We cleaned up the system. I was told that in two things, wrong things used to be done. For instance, in tenders of BSNL, MTNL, etc. And I ensured that no tender file will ever come to a minister's office, ever. And no file came.
Meanwhile, in another Raja saga, even after the former CJI Balakrishnan's smart wordplay in declaring that Raja's name was not on the Justice Gokhale's report, Justice Raghupathy has yet again reiterated that he did mention A. Raja in his letter to the then Chief Justice of the Madras High Court, Justice Gokhale. He confirmed that Raja had attempted to influence him on the phone. Now, while the former Chief Justice of India, Balakrishnan, has denied this, Justice Gokhale had made an explosive disclosure by revealing that the report submitted by him to the CJI did have Raja's name on it.
I was maintaining and adopting judicial code of conduct all these days.
now you are looking me.
Right.
Do you think I am scared or confused?
Right.
Never been.
Sir,
if you people are scared or confused, that is why I told you. I am senior advocate, Supreme Court. Right. I am willing to help you. Come to me.
Right.
I never even asked for security from from anybody.
Right.
I am freely moving around. I am just like an ordinary citizen.
Well, let's talk prison break now. And no, not the popular TV series. Inmates of jails are in news for all the wrong reasons. Name any crime and it's prevalent in the jails. Be it murder or trading of ganja or usage of mobile phones within the jail premises, the criminals have done it all. Topping all of these is the escape of 25-year-old Karthik, a murder suspect. While the police is claiming to be clueless, our crime reporter Salim explores why the walls of the jail are not high enough.
Kural, from where Karthik escaped, has three buildings in the 200-acre facility. The first is for remand prisoners, the second is for convicts, and the third building for women prisoners. Nearly 3,000 prisoners can easily be locked up here safely. Karthik, accused of murdering a couple and fleeing with their jewels, was under trial here. How did he make the great escape?
From the facts and circumstances of the case, which I verified, and that I feel it is definitely the negligence of the prison staff. They owe a responsibility to the society. You can't allow people to escape.
In the wake of the escape, Raja, the officer in charge, has been suspended. And the top brass has also ordered an inquiry against three prison officials. Authorities say the hunt is on.
No, that is being handled by the police department. We are giving complaint to the police department. And police department actually is on the lookout for rearresting the prisoner. We just, you know, some support systems we are doing.
This may be the first time that a prisoner escaped from Pural, but the walls have not been free of illegal activities. Look at the past history. On 2nd August 2008, Grade 2 Warder Solomon was arrested by the Directorate of Vigilance and Anti-Corruption on charges of taking bribe in exchange for providing some facilities to a Sri Lankan national involved in a fake passport case. On 10th June 2009, notorious criminal Wilding Kumar was attacked and killed by fellow inmates. In the wake of the murder, the Tamil Nadu government shunted out R. Nadraj as DGP Prisons and posted him as Director of Fire and Rescue Services. On the 26th of September this year, 53-year-old Kupan, who was serving a life sentence for murdering his wife, committed suicide by hanging. When Pural became operational in 2006, it was touted as a maximum security prison. But the easy escape has set alarm bells ringing. Sources say that the electrical fence surrounding the prison was not operational when the prisoner escaped, pointing a finger to inside help. In Chennai, Salim for NDTV Hindu.
Well, NDTV Hindu makes an impact and gets the Deputy Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu to come and aid of a supposedly overqualified graduate. Find out how in just a short while.